During the Falklands War, any sea vessel or aircraft from any country entering the zone may have been fired upon without further warning. TEZ was an extension of the Maritime Exclusion Zone, MEZ, declared on April 12, 1982, covering the same area. Any Argentine warship or naval auxiliary entering the MEZ could have been attacked by British nuclear-powered submarines, SSN. During the Falklands War, any sea vessel or aircraft from any country entering the zone may have been fired upon without further warning. On April 23, the British government clarified that any Argentine ship or aircraft that was considered to pose a threat to British forces would be attacked in a message that was passed via the Swiss embassy in Buenos Aires to the Argentine government. The civilian aircraft allude particularly, but not only, to the Boeing 707 of the Argentine Air Force that until then had shadowed the British task force on its journey south and had been escorted away on several occasions by Sea Harriers. This has led to much debate and controversy over whether the attack was legal. TEZ was an extension of the Maritime Exclusion Zone, MEZ, declared on April 12, 1982, covering the same area. Any Argentine warship or naval auxiliary entering the MEZ could have been attacked by British nuclear-powered submarines, SSN. However, exclusion zones are historically declared for the benefit of neutral vessels, during war. Under international law, the heading and location of a belligerent naval vessel has no bearing on its status. On April 23, the British government clarified that any Argentine ship or aircraft that was considered to pose a threat to British forces would be attacked in a message that was passed via the Swiss embassy in Buenos Aires to the Argentine government. The civilian aircraft allude particularly, but not only, to the Boeing 707 of the Argentine Air Force that until then had shadowed the British task force on its journey south and had been escorted away on several occasions by Sea Harriers. This has led to much debate and controversy over whether the attack was legal. During the Falklands War, any sea vessel or aircraft from any country entering the zone may have been fired upon without further warning. However, exclusion zones are historically declared for the benefit of neutral vessels. During war, under international law, the heading and location of a belligerent naval vessel has no bearing on its status. TEZ was an extension of the Maritime Exclusion Zone, MEZ, declared on April 12, 1982, covering the same area. Interviews conducted by Martin Middlebrick for his book, The Fight for the Malvinas, indicated that Argentine naval officers understood the intent of the message was to indicate that any ships operating near the exclusion zone could be attacked. Interviews conducted by Martin Middlebrick for his book, The Fight for the Malvinas, indicated that Argentine naval officers understood the intent of the message was to indicate that any ships operating near the exclusion zone could be attacked. Any Argentine warship or naval auxiliary entering the MEZ could have been attacked by British nuclear-powered submarines, SSN.